Here we have the brand new Google Pixel and Google Pixel XL. The XL obviously being the larger one of the two. So there's lots of new features. There's a new design as well. So it's similar. However, now we've got glass on the back here and it's a lot more seamless, much nicer. Got different color schemes and a little bit of flashing, a little flash of color with the orange button. Throwing a little bit of fun in there to a design that could otherwise be quite boring. When you think about all the phones we've got at the moment, they all kind of look the same. The Pixel is going out there on a bit of a limb and showing it's quite different. The screen aren't quite edge to edge, so we actually have a bezel that goes around, particularly noticeable on the smaller Pixel. And we've got slightly curved edges on the screen on the XL, like we've seen on the iPhone X recently, but also on the likes of the LG G6 and the Samsung Galaxy S8. What we've got is two very nice phones. They both pack the same specs. So you've got the same Snapdragon 835 processor, you've got the same 12 megapixel camera. You don't get anything different on the XL than you do on the normal Pixel. The differences are, obviously, one is larger. That also means that the screen is a higher resolution. You've got Quad HD here, you've got Full HD here. However, both of these screens are OLED, and that means really brilliant blacks and contrast ratios. So it's going to be a very, very nice phone to watch films on, but also very, very good for virtual reality. And of course, Daydream is the other area that Google has focused on at its event, which is its virtual reality headset, the Daydream View. So that these phones will slot into that and provide a very, very nice VR experience with up to 250 apps now, actually. So that ecosystem is growing nicely. The other difference, of course, is battery size. So you have a much larger battery in the larger phone. However, Google hasn't told us yet quite how much stamina each one of these will have. So we don't know how long they will last, but expect, like other larger phones, for the XL to last a bit longer than the normal Pixel. And we now also have stereo front-firing speakers. You can just about see the grooves there, on the front there, and here. I quite like the way these are located, because you can't really hide, you can't really cover them if you're watching something. They're not underneath here, which are easily covered like that. These are firing straight at your face. So the sound should be really, really good and really clear. Of course, there's one other big difference, and that is the price. The smaller Pixel comes in at $649. We don't have UK pricing yet. The larger Pixel at $849. So obviously that's a big old difference for phones that are essentially packing the same components, aside from some small differences. For more on the Pixel and the Pixel XL, join us on trustreviews.com.